What is up, everyone? It's the Drummer Nerd, and welcome back to ARK Survival Evolved. Today, we're going to play around with one of the new items that just came out in the Industrial Forge. So you'll see I'm out on my metal base. There's a couple changes here, nothing too crazy. I ended up leveling out the roof here because the Industrial Forge is massive, and there was no way that we'd actually be able to fit it inside. Which kind of works out because right now, and I'll show you the process here as it goes a little bit, but right now, it's a little bit of a pain in the butt to get all of the metal into where the forges are. So I felt if we put the forge on top of the roof here, then I can just fly and land my Quetzal on top here, who's got, you know, pretty close to 3,000 weight, and we could just dump the metal into the iron industrial forge. I'm going to say that a lot. I've been doing that past couple days. I've been talking about it, and I keep calling it an iron forge. It's not. Stop saying that, nerd. Stop it. So we got a behemoth gate here, and I made a metal behemoth gate because I came over here the other day, and there was a Giga just kind of chilling out on the mountainside over here. I managed to kind of chase him off the mountain a little bit. I think he's still down here rampaging around. Things are terrifying, man. I don't want to be, like, out and about trying to get my metal, doing my thing. Look at this. There he is. Just rampaging around the bottom of this mountain. Not having it. So he was within eye shot of my metal base. No. No. No, we don't want that. We don't want none of that. No, thank you. So, you know, it kind of stinks because I kind of shut myself off a little bit from some of the metal that comes on down here. But there really is plenty of metal on this mountain. It's really not that big of a deal. I just, you know, I would much rather lose out on a little bit of metal than potentially have one of my dinos get murdered because that big boy is just hanging out. So I'm going to land Detective Flaps over here. And go grab Hank, the Anklo. I do like to just kind of have Flaps around with me because of the weight. And because Hank doesn't really have a lot of weight. There's really not a lot you can do about that. The weight on these guys is so low. And when you start pumping weight into them, it doesn't go up by much. So they really can't hold on to a lot. And they're very slow. But they break metal awesomely. Watch this. Kerplap. 217 metal already. And I can't move. So this is kind of... Oh yeah, I realize now I have all that stuff on me and I'm still wearing... fur. Fur is heavy. So we can just dump this stuff on to Flapsy here. Flaps, hold my cementing paste, please. And actually, now that I think about it, let's get a little bit nudies for you guys. Ooh, sorry, cover your eyes. Let's get this fur stuff off of me. And on to Flaps. There we go. So now that we can actually take some of the metal back and forth and dump it onto him. So you can see it's a decent process because you get a lot of metal fairly quickly, especially having this Anklo. I mean, he can burst through these rocks pretty quick, but you have to kind of go back and forth. It takes a little bit of time, so I'm going to spend a little bit of time gathering up as much of this metal as I can, and we'll be back when we're ready to start cooking it up. All right, while we wait for our refining forges to finish cooking up all the metal we need for this industrial forge, I figured we'd take a little bit of time gathering up some of the organic polymer, because we do need 400 polymer to make what we're trying to make, and it's fairly expensive to make that stuff when you have to find obsidian to make it normally. So now that they added the Kairuku as a source of organic polymer, we can come out and we can just kind of wipe the place clean of them. Hopefully finding enough of these guys before the wolves get to them. And look, already 18 organic polymer. Now, as we've tested before, you get a whole lot more polymer when you use a club to gather it. Problem with that is clubs break really, really fast and really, really easy. Making them... Oh my gosh, look at that thing fly. Making them not very useful for gathering this stuff. I'd rather be a little bit inefficient with gathering the polymer and not have to carry around 50 clubs because one of them will break nearly immediately on just one of the Kairuku. So we need 400 of this stuff. And you can see that we're getting it pretty quickly, so this shouldn't really take too long. I mean, we just cleared the first little camp of the guys, and we've got 10, 20, 30, 40, 50... So we're getting there, but these guys do spoil. Now again, our spoil timers are turned up a little bit, so this is going to be a little bit easier for me than it might be for you. But the stuff does spoil in about 30 minutes on an official server. So I wanted to wait until we were fairly close to finished with all the metal so that we didn't have too much time that we were sitting on the stuff and possibly having it spoil. So we'll take a little bit of time getting stuck in the trees and probably fighting off a couple of Rexes to gather up all the organic polymer that we need. Die, Rex, die. This isn't even my combat dino. You just die. Thank you for the levels. Hey, what are you doing out here? It's also worth noting if you are out here gathering up polymer from the Kairukus that the younger they are, the more you get. So, you know, killing babies, I guess, made okay in Ark. You might feel a little bad about it. I kind of do. Especially because I really like the Kairuku. Alright, look at all this. Now, here's the trick. I gotta not knock them all away when I'm fighting. And that one's stuck in the ground. Problem with using a Quetzal for this is the fact that you knock them all away and they kind of blend into the environment a little bit. Okay. So this shouldn't take too long. I'll get to this and hopefully all the metal will be done when we get back to base. And we should be able to make the industrial forge as soon as we're back. So let's get this done and I'll meet you guys back there. All right, here we go. Last set of metal. I still got these guys going because they do still have some wood in a lot of these, so this is going to give us the charcoal that we need for more and more gunpowder. And as you can imagine, as soon as we get the industrial forge done, we're really not going to need to use the refining forges anymore for making metal, so what I'll probably do is swing up here every once in a while with a ton of wood and just let them cook and get all the charcoal we can ever dream of for making gunpowder so we can get more and more bullets. Let's grab a little bit of gasoline off of our generator here. And we'll turn on this noisy bad boy. Look at the requirements for this thing. 2,500 metal ingots, 250 crystals, 600 cementing paste, 400 oil, and 400 polymer. Insane. It just cleared out the whole inventory on this thing. Oh, but I am excited to place this thing down. All right, so we'll leave those guys to cook there for a little bit. All right. Hey, let me jump on you. Thank you very much. I gotta try to land him on a... Oh, no, that's not gonna work. We gotta try to land on a corner because this thing is supposed to be massive. I'm not sure exactly how big it's gonna be. I think I'm gonna try to place it in that back corner there. And hopefully we'll be able to get the flapses up here. Oh, man. Your face is bothering me right now. Holy cow. Okay, so let's just see if we can get this. I don't know, here? Sure, why not? Ooh. Wow. Look at the size of that thing. And it's kind of sticking off the edge. I wish it didn't do that. Well, it's alright. We can put some ceilings on there or something. Figure that out. Let's get flaps a little bit closer. Can I reach both inventories from here? Yeah. I did a little bit of extra gathering of metal with flaps here. So, let's grab some oil first. And now that I think about it, I'm actually going to need some gas from downstairs. So this is a little bit less prepared than I'd like to be. But let's drop some of these guys in here. I thought I had more hide than this. I did. Okay. So with the industrial forge, you can cook up both metal and gasoline. And it does so at an incredibly increased rate. And it's very, very efficient with its use of gas. So to give you some numbers while I flop around trying to get all the gasoline that I need to make this thing run, which is going to allow us to get more gasoline so that we can make it run even longer. And I don't know why Flaps has been doing this. Every time he lands, every time Flaps lands here, her face goes into the ground, just kind of glitches out. Early access. So with the refining forge, you can get one metal ingot every 20 seconds. And you can get one gasoline every 30 seconds. Let's grab like 10. We won't need this because this thing is very, very efficient. Why did I do that? I hit the wrong button. We'll have to cut that out. Maybe I'll cut it out. You guys didn't see anything. I won't cut it out. Conversely, I believe it's 15 ingots every 20 seconds in this big guy. Just dump it all in there. Turn it on. Ooh. Look at how cool that looks. That is so sweet. Stop it, Flaps. Your face is in my way. I believe that we should see in 30 seconds how much gasoline we'll get. So right now we're at 9. And we'll just wait. Play a little bit of Jeopardy music. Do 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 do. Do 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 do. Oh, there it is. Holy cow. Was that 75? 75 gasoline in 30 seconds. Holy cow. Well, we won't really need to worry about our gasoline collection anymore now, will we? Alright, Flaps, let's get you a little bit closer so I can get the rest of this metal. What? Stop. Stop. Your face is in the forge now. That is cool because I can reach both. I think this is the best part about doing this is putting this on the roof so that I could actually just grab what I need off of Flaps here and dump it straight on. Because before we were only able to carry one stack at a time and we had to basically run a stack inside to the refining forges and just let it go. Look at how much gasoline we're getting. That is so awesome. Oh my gosh. See, yeah, 15 ingots every 20 seconds. Is it doing both at the same time? I can't tell if it's doing one at a time or both at the same time. That's even better if it's doing both at the same time, because you can just pile in whatever you need to and it's going to cook up. Let's see, another couple seconds and we should see more gasoline here. Come on. You can do. Oh my gosh. That thing is so cool. So we'll let that run for just a little bit. From what I understand, one gasoline on those guys will get you somewhere near 1,000 or a little bit more than 1,000 metal ingots. The efficiency is just craziness. Absolute craziness. And what we want to do next is I crawl back into my very bright and this place has got to be so hot. Where did I put it? Was it here? Yeah, look at all this charcoal we got. I already had some from before. So we'll dump a little bit of the charcoal in here. And a little bit of the charcoal in here. I need one more. I want to make up some gunpowder with all this newfound metal glory that we have going on. And I think I'm going to have to make a pit stop over at RC's base, because I think that he's got a ramshackle long neck rifle pattern. Because we certainly don't want to make a basic rifle if we're going to go shooting stuff. So let's get some of this gunpowder cooked up. We'll wait for that to cook up. We'll wait for some more of our metal to cook up. And then we'll head over to RC's base to get a new gun made. Made it to RC's base. This place keeps getting bigger and bigger and bigger. And bigger and bigger and bigger. Let's see. I'm not going to be able to carry everything in one go, unfortunately. Just grab a couple wood. Get some hide. I don't really mind if I leave extras here for him. This one? There it is. We didn't need that much wood, but here you go, buddy. You can have some wood. 213 metal ingots. I should probably grab exactly 200 and... That's a 13? Wow, my brain just stopped working entirely for a second there. Well, let's dump this 200 on first. 213. Okay, so I only need 13 more. Come here. Give me your metal. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. What? Yeah, 13. Sweet. Let's make this gun. So the reason I'm making a second one is you can't put attachments on the guns that you use tranquilizer darts on. Which kind of makes it pointless. Whatever. I want to put an attachment on this. I want a scope because this is going to be my regular bullets gun. Come here. Scope. And the obvious necessities here. Some color. Let's color this guy up real quick. I like that to be blue. Let's start with the stuff that's going to be orange, huh? That's got to be orange. Do we want that? Yeah, I want that to be orange. But we'll blue up. No. Okay. We'll blue that part up. Q. And the scope. Q. And bullets. Look at this bad boy. Awesome. And I can actually... Oh, Blizzard. Let's get out of here, Flaps. I don't like this place anymore. Let's go find some pteranodons to shoot or something. Alright, let's give this new gun bad boy a check. Oh. Okay. So, new turkey event. That's the super turkey. You don't want to mess with the super turkey. Especially not with this giant Bronto here. Because these guys, when you attack them, will aggro everything that doesn't normally aggro, and it hurts really bad. And they got a lot of health, apparently, too. So, we're not going to play around with that. Instead, we're going to go for these dodos. Let's get all ready for it. It's coming right for us! Ooh. Oh, let's try this one. Pteranodon? Oh, I missed entirely. It turned at the last second. I'm gonna blame the turning. Stop turning. Oh, I missed entirely. I'm really terrible aim with this. There we go. Down you go, big bird. What else we got? Not you. That's not gonna work out. Ooh, hey, Dodo. We're gonna sneak up on it. Shh. Stop making noise, guys. You're making too much noise. We're gonna scare it away. Dodo. BAM! Oh, this thing is awesome. Just drag that around to throw you. Is that same turkey? You're scary, Turkey. Let's see. Let's try something a little bit bigger. I don't think I'll be able to mess with a trike too much. What level are you? You're level 20. Let's get a better angle on you. Bam! There's a little hurt. Oh, you can't come up here, can you? Bam! Gonna have to no-scope. This one's a little close. Oh, wow, look at how much damage that does. This is the body. Uh-huh. That probably missed. Yeah! Super gun. Love it. Oh, that turkey, so scary. Prone. Mm-hmm. Gotta breathe in before you take this shot. Oh, what? Breathe in before you... Yeah. Target down. All right, everyone, that's gonna do it for me today. Thanks again for watching. If you, why is that? No. That used to work so cool. Ah, well. If you like today's video, go ahead and drop that like button for me. Really appreciate it. If you like the Industrial Forge as much as I do, because I think it's super awesome, tell me about it. Let me know in the comments. Love hearing from you. If you like all the stuff you've been seeing so far, the videos, they're okay. They're all right. Maybe you like it enough. You subscribe to it. You can hear when I got more videos coming out. Hey, we'll see you next time. Thanks again. Bye-bye.